Art is all around us. These words belong to an absolutely obsessive person who has devoted his life unselfishly to art. His collection has long been legendary. In the State Art Museum of the Republic of Karakalpakstan, everything has to do with Igor Savitsky. The history of the museum, the formation of the unique collections, the mysterious names of Russian and Turkestan avant-garde artists who are still waiting for their researchers. There are many books, numerous articles, and documentary films about this collection and about Igor Savitsky himself. It is difficult to remain indifferent to the personality of a person who, having left his apartment in the center of Moscow, moves to the Nukus in the 1950s and got a unique collection. But for the first time, Savitsky got in Central Asia even earlier, during the Great Patriotic War. Then the Moscow Art Institute, where he studied, was evacuated to Samarkand. The city has shaken the young artist to his core, with its architectural monuments, originality and culture. That's where he met modern artists Konstantin Istomin and Robert Falk, who became his teachers. The 2 years he spent in Samarkand largely determined his fate, and a few years later, after arriving in Central Asia for the second time, he decided to stay forever in this region. That's what the reserve Karakalpakstan was like, and it became his second homeland. I always dreamed of Central Asia while I was still studying during the war in Samarkand. In the 1950s, I was offered to go to the archaeological and ethnographic expedition of Tolstoy. So I got to Karakalpakstan, and somehow I liked it. Working as an artist in the expedition of academician Sergei Tolstoy, Igor Savitsky dreamed of creating a museum in which unique archaeological finds would be collected. For him, romantic by nature, it was nearly impossible to not admire the grandiose ancient fortifications and the deposits of which were hidden the artifacts of distant powerful states. The territory of modern Karakalpakstan is the land of ancient Khwarezm. I will now show you an amazing collection. It is the collection of late antiquity of the 1st through 4th century and the Middle Ages. All that is presented in this department of the exposition is the findings of the Khwarezmian archaeological expedition. It is amazing in its own artistic and historical significance works. They indicate a high level of crafts in ancient Khwarezm. Many of them date from the 4th through 3rd centuries before Christ. These are the clay vessels from the Khoi Krilgan Kala and Jambaz Kala. Already then, they were created on a potter's wheel. There are many findings associated with various religious cults. Zoroastrian ossuary in the form of a lion camel. This is the 1st century before Christ. On the surface of the ossuary, there are symbolic images. Experts say that this is the tamga of the ruling Khwarezm dynasty, whose lineage goes back to the mythological hero Siavash. Along with numerous chest-shaped ossuaries, the collection also has a statue-shaped one in the form of a man. It was created in the 2nd-3rd century. These beads, twisted bracelets, necklaces, and bronze hairpins were found in the Saka burials. The sculpture of a horse from Tuymuyun is connected with the cult of the solar god Mitra, who was depicted as a heavenly rider. On the side of the sculpture, there are traces of the rider's leg bent at the knee. This terracotta sculpture with slipware dates back to the 7th century. Early Muslim culture is represented by glazed pottery. Among them, the so-called luster pottery is considered to be special. It is distinguished by a picturesque thematic painting in the style of Oriental miniatures. The museum has a whole collection of wonderful encaustic tiles which served as a decoration for palaces, mosques, madrasas, and mausoleums. This exquisite drawing is a fragment of the wall painting, which once adorned the palace halls of Kızılkale. Karakalpaks is a small, semi-nomadic ethnic nation with an ancient history and a distinctive culture. And for the first time, a presentation of its decorative and applied art was held at the opening of the museum in 1966. It is these works without which it is impossible to imagine the life of Karakalpaks, which were the first one in the Igor Savitsky's collection. The small people in the recent past, lost among the sands and channels of the Amudarya, had magnificent art, amazing craftsmanship, impeccable taste, and an amazing tact in the distribution of ornament and color, wrote Savitsky. And he tirelessly tried to find in the most remote villages folk crafts which now decorate the halls of the museum. Karakalpaks have a very developed punchwork, and it is so deep that it often creates a relief like a sculpture. And then the Karakalpaktings are not very feminine. Here is such a fringe from the chains, like here, or like these haikels, where a similar massive part is combined with a transparent fringe. This gives them some kind of a unique solution and some kind of softness. If Turkmen's jewels are so warlike, courageous, then Karakalpak's one has a warmer character, they are more intimate. Igor Vitalievich did not just collect works of decorative and applied art, but for decades studied them scrupulously. The funds of the State Art Museum of the Republic of Karakalpakstan carefully store Savitsky's personal archive, his letters and notes on field. These are the heartful confessions where he sincerely wrote about the art of the region with which he linked his destiny. Unexpectedly, a new world was opened, the world of folk genius, folk wisdom and folk aesthetics. Karakalpaks managed to find and bring to our days a special understanding of the beauty, we read in one of his letters. Indeed, literally every work of decorative and applied art in his collection, be it clothes, richly decorated with embroidery, wedding accessories, or traditional ornaments of a yurt, in each case is a single, unusually complete ensemble. This is a huge world of ornamental images that had developed over the centuries. The women's outfit, Kokoylik, is connected with the ancient militant tribes of the Massagete, who lived a few thousand years ago on the coast of the Aral. This ritual, homespun wedding dress of the bride, adorned with magnificent embroidery, is in fact the magic sign of the future life. The helmets of the ancient Saka and Massagete warriors resemble ancient wedding headdresses. The oldest of them is Tobilik, evidence of high skill of Karakalpak's jewelers. It is created from thin sheet silver and is richly decorated with semi-precious stones. It is said that in former times, in each major village worked its own jeweler, Zerger. The decoration of the nomad's tent included a variety of carpet items, carpets, felt, woven ornamented paths. Their patterns are extremely diverse. Old masters know about more than 60 of them. All these patterns had a sacral significance. But how was this collection created? Savitsky writes, "Once I saw an old rug, which closed the log in the irrigation ditch. I had no money anymore. I spent both my own and the public money. I had to sell my boots so that the rug did not swim away from me." At one time, rumors about a strange Russian man collecting ancient things scattered around the villages in the regions of Karakalpakstan. Truly, it was a selfless, titanic work, the result of which was a unique collection of not only decorative and applied art, but also painting. Igor Vitalievich actually played a very huge role in the development of fine art and the education of several generations of Karakalpak's artists. Savitsky had an impeccable taste. He was a very educated man. He was an artist, too. When he collected the works, not all of them turned out to be masterpieces by the artists. There is a lot of preparatory material, but if there was an opportunity, he tried to collect the whole works, starting from some sketches and ending with such mature works. Valentina Егоровна Сычева is the main curator of the museum. She knows the history of each collection for certain, and she's one of those who directly worked with Igor Savitsky. Our collection is so diverse in its artistic significance. Here are represented various artist groups that existed in the early 1920s and 30s. This is the artists of the world of art and many others. The first picturesque work, which Savitsky acquired for the museum, was a picture of Alexander Volkov Caravan. It is listed in Invert Books at number 1 and is not accidental. This was a bold, extraordinary decision made by Igor Savitsky, which eventually brought the museum world fame. He deliberately collected the canvases of representatives of the so-called Turkestan and Russian avant-garde, then blamed for the formalism. Getting this collection, Igor Savitsky set himself a very noble goal to revive undeservedly forgotten names and groups of artists who worked in the 20-30 years of the last century and were almost rejected by official criticism. And judging by these funds, these were not individual names or individual masterpieces. For the first time, we have a real picture of the art development. The memories of Alexander Volkov's son, Valery Volkov, about how Igor Savitsky got this unique collection of paintings have been preserved. Imagine such a situation. A man comes into a house of some artist's widow and says, "Here I am, the director of the museum in Nukus. So I write to you on a piece of paper a receipt, and you give me works for such a sum of money." Everybody run to me and ask, "Is he not a crook?" He goes from door to door, collects paintings, and writes something on paper without the mark. Just, "I'm Savitsky, the director of the museum." I say, "Give it to him." But what about the guarantees? I guarantee that, because I give him my father's works too. The exposition of the museum presents a whole series of works by one of the classics of the 20th century, Alexander Volkov. These are the paintings created since 1910. They're mainly the monumental compositions and deeply lyrical works of the last decade of the master's life. Volkov's works were in a very poor condition when Savitsky acquired them. There were a lot of losses of a paint layer, and he took them from the Volkov sons, who kept them on a roller like that, and in the damp apartment where they and many other canvases would simply have been destroyed if Savitsky did not get them on time and did not take them to the restoration. Thus, the mission of Savitsky, he considered himself to be a rescuer and a discoverer of the new artists, was fully completed. Despite all the differences and richness of individual manners, the conventional artist language, brevity, and symbolism of images is what united avant-gardists. Poetry and understatement distinguished the works of Alexander Nikolaev, who entered the history of art under the name of Ustomomin. Their inspired, integral, and full of harmony images created through a deep understanding of the classical art of the West and the East. Early works of Ural Tansikbaev and Nikolai Karakhan were for everyone an unexpected discovery. Igor Savitsky collected several hundred works of these original artists. Contrasting color combinations, intense coloring, all of these in the works of the early period of the artist's creativity, amazed with their skill and still require comprehension. There are a lot of very wonderful works that Savitsky considered to be masterpieces. For example, there is the curtains work. Of course, it requires restoration because the painting began to exfoliate a little. Therefore, our restorers made prom gluing. This work was made in 1957. The artist, according to Savitsky, had such a powerful temperament and could have done so much for his life. But his fate was very tragic. He spent almost 20 years in Stalin's camps, and this work was written literally in the year of his death. He died in 1957. In the paintings of Mikhail Kurzin, there are no random details. Art critics claim that he was able to single out with only one line the main thing, something special. A man of tragic fate, he was twice repressed and came from his pacified in calm work of the early period to the style of Frank Grotesque and Phantasmagoria. Showing you the collections of the Nukus Museum, we certainly could not help but mention the picturesque legacy of Igor Savitsky himself. There are many sketches fixing his first impression and his completed landscapes in the museum's collection. He writes the patriarchal way of life of the Karakalpaks, investing in his works all love and pain for this land. Once these lands were the bottom of the Aral Sea, and now, as you can see, here is only a cemetery of ships, a cemetery of old fishing schooners. And only there, on the horizon, you can see a small strip of water. It is very cold and very quiet here, and this is a frightening silence. The Aral theme became one of the main themes for the Karakalpaks artists of the new generation of the 1970s and 80s. Today, the works of Izintayev, Saparov, Lipesov, and Utomuratov are a classic of Karakalpaks art. The creativity of these artists was considered to be a phenomenon of the national school. The collection of our museum for today is 99,695 exhibits, of which more than a half is works of fine art. Our film crew, for the first time, has the opportunity to shoot works that are stored in the museum's new collections. Here, there are a lot of paintings and graphic works on how these funds were collected. We can also learn it from the collector himself, thanks to the shots of the Chronicle. We are here in the painting fund. This is one of the main departments of our museum. And it contains about 3,000 works by different artists. Only a small part of them is in the exposition. The rest is stored here on our shelves. And we hope that when we build a museum, we can show them to the people. Savitsky had his own collection method, not only to create the art gallery, but he tried, if there was an opportunity, to bring the creativity of this or that artist entirely. Along with the works of masters constantly living and working in Uzbekistan, in the collection of the Nukus Museum, a large place is occupied by paintings and graphics works by Russian avant-gardists, now classics of art. Among them, there are many high-profile names: Falk, Rozhdestvensky, Yusupov, Osmyrkin, Shevchenko, Mazel, Istomin, Karavay. The numerous canvases in the museum's funds are waiting for their researchers. This work belongs to Falk. In our collection, we have 13 works of this famous artist. Savitsky, after the death of Falk, turned to his widow, Щёкин Кротова, and she was able to offer him 13 works that came to our museum. These works were, of course, masterpieces. This is one of the works of Stavrovsky, his early period. It was written in 1931. We have little work of the early period of Stavrovsky, mainly the 1970s. Well, this work is not typical for him, because the painting is different in its explosive nature. He portrays an elderly woman with such a kind of poignancy. The works of this artist has not yet been studied, but the museum's funds hold 2,200 of them. And these are works of Nikolai Tarasov. There are about 1,000 of them in the Nukus Museum. This is a series of works dedicated to Alexander Sergeyevich Pushkin. Savitsky went sometimes for a whole month, and then called that such a train would stop in Khojaly, because in those years, in the 1970s, when Savitsky was intensely collecting, we did not have a station here. There was no railway, and he had to go to Khojaly. Khojaly is 40 kilometers from Nukus. He loaded the wagons completely. There were paintings, graphics, and sculpture. And of course, it was impossible to unload all this in 10 minutes. And the train stopped sometimes for half an hour or for an hour. Thus, in Nukus Museum has assembled an exclusive collection of works by artists such as Klement Redzko, Pavel Surikov, Boris Rybchenkov, and Nikolai Grigoriev. They are little-known artists to a wide audience. Their work is shown today for the first time. For the first time, thanks to the selfless work of Igor Savitsky, visitors to the Nukus Museum could see copies of the world's great masterpieces. This is a collection of the French artist Fernand Léger, which was created for it in the workshops of the Louvre. After the death of Léger, his wife Nadia Léger presented a significant part of the collection to the Soviet Union. All these copies Savitsky himself selected and brought from Moscow to his museum in 1975. His choice is another evidence of impeccable taste and genuine professionalism in getting the collection. I remember I could hardly sleep because it was necessary to do everything very quickly.
and it is always very difficult to make the exposition, but you feel some joy in the result. Therefore, this is such a personal matter. If a person finds his satisfaction in this, the meaning of his life, then everything goes very simply. The collection of the State Art Museum of the Republic of Karakalpakstan, named after Igor Savitsky, is not only a unique large-scale collection. The museum has become a truly scientific base for researchers of known and unknown pages of the art history of a vast region and for the creativity of artists fascinated by the East. Russian museums not want to cooperate with us, including the Pushkin State Museum of Fine Arts and the Третьяков Gallery. A lot of specialists, art critics, and artists are turning to work in the funds of our museum to study the creativity of certain artists, and joint exhibitions are being held. In this way, Karakalpakstan has become a home place, and the museum somehow became the main thing in my life. So I stayed here and do not want a different life for myself. And so, here in Nukus, where the scent of the Kızılkum desert begins just outside the city, in the 1960s was created such a diverse, special, and unique collection, which is now very interesting for people, literally, from all over the world. Once, Igor Savitsky said that the time will come and people from different countries will come here to see our museum. Today, this is really true. This is a project Treasures of the Cultural Legacy of Uzbekistan in the World Museums with Shahnoza Ganiyeva. Thank you for your attention.